Okay, so this is Blessing, and the date is 13th of September, and we're doing the evaluation for summer game time. All right, so tell me your experience of your experience on summer game time, doing work experience, and also take part in the trips and the employability skills workshops.
I enjoyed everything. I find looking after children differently, but fun, because I've never done anything like that. The trips were a nice experience, because I don't go on trips often. Mm-hmm. So that was nice. Mm-hmm. And overall, I'm happy with how I chose to spend my summer working at the mentoring lab. But it was a good experience.
Good experience. Can you tell me about some of the challenges that you had on the work experience and what changes you've made to your life since?
Probably getting distracted. I've kind of distanced myself from some of the people I work in other places like school. Yeah, I don't really get distracted like how I used to get distracted.
So from that, I'm understanding that I'm interpreting as you've gone back to school and you're less distracted.
Yeah.
And what impact is that having on you at school?
I'm studying more and like understanding work more than I used to.
And how long have you been back at school since?
2 weeks. Well, like no, a week and a half.
A week and a half. Would you say that's a positive or a negative?
Positive.
I would say it's positive. What else was a challenge for you during the work experience that you've now made changes to? Okay, there's one thing that I'm thinking of, something that yourself and Malia were struggling with.
Coming early. Yeah.
Talk to me about that.
I've not been late ever since I started school.
Really?
Yeah, not once.
So what about with your participation with the Voyage, the other youth mentoring project that you're... or youth organisation that you're part of?
Coming late.
Yeah. Well, I know you did a residential, so it's like you can't really be late at a residential because you're always there. But in terms of like waking up and just showing up on time?
I struggled with coming late. So
okay. Late. What about now that you started back at school?
I haven't done that.
No, I mean with school.
Oh, I've been early to school every day. I haven't been late once.
Have your... family, the people in your household, have they noticed the difference?
Yes.
And what have they said?
They were they're shocked because I'm usually late to school every day, and I reckon.
What changes did you make?
Sleep earlier.
What time? Give me specifics.
Like 10 o'clock.
What time were you going to bed before?
Pardon?
What time were you going to bed before?
Like 3
in the morning.
It's bad.
Tell me a bit more about that. Why were you going to bed at 3 in the morning? Like, be honest.
My sleeping pattern.
Okay.
No, I'll just be on my phone.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how do you go to bed at 10 o'clock now? Like, what's your...
go to my phone, like, hit it somewhere, just lay and sleep.
I'm really proud of you. I'm proud of you. What year are you in at school?
Year 10.
Okay, so this is, like, GCSE.
Yeah.
Prep year. What else do you do to ensure you're on time for school in the morning?
Pack my bag the day before as well. Yeah, that's it.
Anything else? No? These are like really small things that you've changed but make a really significant difference. Yeah? What about your eating habits? I've just wondered, yeah.
I don't eat like that. I know it's not, but it's like,
you don't eat like that, would you?
Like, I know I should be eating often, but I rarely eat.
You rarely eat? When you eat, do you eat? What do you eat?
Chicken and tea. Maybe rice, pasta. Sometimes cultural food.
Did you learn anything about healthy eating when you were with us? What did you learn?
That it's important.
Mm.
In terms of growth and mental health.
I want you to think about how you can switch up that chicken and chips for something healthier.
Absolutely.
As a life goal. you don't have to think about it now. Just when you, after this evaluation meeting and the days and the weeks, you know, to come, just think about it. Especially with you being in year 10, your brain needs energy and fuel to do the work that needs to get done. For you to revise and retain the information, to keep the information in your brain. And eating has got a massive role to play in it. Yeah. I'm not here to lecture you today. I'm here to find out how the summer went. All right. Okay. So I'm now going to the form that you completed. You put yourself at excellent and strongly agree or agree for most of the things. Right?
Yeah.
You spoke about getting involved in sports more. That's one of the improvements that you'd like to make. Do you get involved in sports during the week in your, like in your normal, yeah, well, in school no. And just in your normal, okay. Can I ask why?
I don't know. But I'm quite active in PE.
Yeah. Oh, thank God for PE then. Is it just that you're not interested in sports at all?
Kind of.
Do you like doing icebreakers, like especially the physical ones? When you're like moving around and getting interactive. Yeah, that's what we sensed. We struggled with icebreakers this year because we found that some people just didn't want to engage really. So something that we need to make improvements of are icebreakers that you can do where maybe you do it individually and then join the main group. Does that make sense? Yeah. You spoke about two things that you wanted to improve on were food options and doing more sports activities with both boys and girls as well?
Yeah.
Is there anything you would like to say about how we could improve the work experience process for next year? And you can be absolutely honest here.
I don't think I would change anything because everything was simple.
It was simple. Go on.
I can't think of anything.
It was simple, but it was a challenge. So most young people, and I know that yourselves, when I'm speaking to yourselves and, well, let me speak on you. Sometimes the request to be on time, the request to be putting in more effort and energy was a challenge. That's my observation. That's my experience. But you kept coming. Your time improved. You became dependable. Like, I was able to depend on you. And actually, when you guys left to go and do the fantastic residential that you did with Voyage, you were hugely missed. And that is because you made yourself valuable. Do you see? Like, you became an asset. And this is what is required in the workplace. You want to be seen as useful, as an asset, as someone that gives something to the team. So whatever you do going forward, I don't know if we're going to see you next year, but I'm saying anything that you do going forward, put that same effort, energy, and that ability to reflect on how you're bringing yourself, how you're showing up, and how you can improve to everything that you do. Okay? Really, I just wanted to call your parents and say, huh? Whereabouts have they gone camping? I'm coming to get them. Yeah? And the young people missed you too. Okay? So well done.
Thank you.
I know it's a different type of program. I know we're not all about having fun. We're literally here to ensure that by the time you're ready for employment, your qualities, your character, and also your experience of like helping out in teams, using your initiative, reflection matches the job that you're going to go for. Do you see? So I hope it will make a long lasting impact on your life. Okay. Cool. Any final thoughts to anybody that wants to do the work experience program next year? Like prep them.
I would say be on time, interact with the children, enjoy your experience. Don't do it just for the money, but for the actual experience, because it is fun. And yeah.
Any final thoughts on you? Do you want to say anything to yourself? You don't want to say well done?
Actually, well done. Actually, I also
well done. Well done. Yeah, definitely. All right. Cool. How old are you?
14.